And here comes Barry Bonds.
I think I'll stand this time, too. Get a better look.
And they have to put the specially marked baseballs into play here.
You know what we ought to ask Mike Vasek and John Lannon if they feel differently. Sometimes when they mark those special balls up, there's a different feel to them.
He's put two great swings on the ball tonight. Up and away, ball one from Mike Vasek. One night facing a rookie left-hander, the next night a journeyman left-hander.
And every pitch looks like a 4th of July fireworks show.
Two balls and no strikes and a breaking ball away. Evidently, John Hirschbeck lifted the ball, thought it was well enough to stay in the game. Home runs have been flying out of AT&T Park tonight.
it's funny when you go through something like this. They boo every pitch out of the strike zone and boo every pitch that's called a strike.
Yeah.
And Barry's taking swings like he's in the home run derby during the All-Star game. Not the compact swings he took when he was hitting so many home runs. This is a, every swing is an I want to get this over with right now swing. The 3-1 pitch last night off Lannon was an out of control swing.
That's ball three and a breaking ball low and away. And they had him leaning. That's a foul ball.
How so?
You wonder how that ball could be foul when it was twisting to the right and Dimitri Young caught it barely to the right of the chalk line.
Levity there in the moment as Mike Vasek tried to catch the ball behind his back. Kind of lets you know he's not too uptight about all of this.
3-2 to Bonds. And there it goes. This ball is history. Willie Mays awaits.
Barry has said that in his career, passing Willie Mays, his godfather, is the one that stood out the most in his life. It's an amazing moment to see this happen, and it will be the answer to a question forever. Who's the man who passed Hank Aaron? Unfortunately, it will always leave a lot of unanswered questions.
I would like to offer my congratulations to Barry Bonds on becoming baseball's career home run leader. It is a great accomplishment which requires skill, longevity, and determination. Throughout the past century, the home run has held a special place in baseball, and I have been privileged to hold this record for 33 of those years. I move over now and offer my best wishes to Barry and his family on this historical achievement. My hope today, as it was on that April evening in 1974, is that the achievement of this record will inspire others to chase their own dream.
Hank Aaron, everybody, passing the torch to you, Barry Bonds.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I gotta thank all of you, all the fans here in San Francisco. Road and home, it's been fantastic. I want to thank you all. I got to thank my teammates for their support. Through all this, you guys have been strong, and you've given me all the support in the world, and I'll never forget it as long as I live. Thank you. I got to thank my family, my mother, my wife Liz, my kids, Nikolai, Shikari, and Asia. I'm glad I did it before you guys went to school. Thanks for being here. I gotta thank the Washington Nationals for your support. Thank you for understanding this day. It means a lot to me. My dad.
We love you,
man! Thank you for everything. Thank you.
Unbelievably classy message from the great Henry Aaron,
who has been awfully quiet through all of this, but I think anybody who knows him is not surprised that the class and the elegance of Hank Aaron would show at a moment like this.
Now, having seen what we've seen and a little bit of history here on this swing, it was a typical Barry Bonds homer. Deepest part of the ballpark, Don.
Here's a look at the pitch sequence. Mike Bassett got himself into a situation where he had to throw a strike. A beauty to make it 2-1. A big home run swing there. That's the pitch he wanted him to chase. Now 3-2, you got to come down Broadway. And he does with the breaking ball that was just foul. But the fastball belt high inner half might do it. Barry Bonds knew it. 43,000 others here knew it. And Mike Bassick, who came back out to warm up now, took off his cap and tipped it in the direction of the Giants dugout. Another touch of class to an amazing evening.
That's Barry's son, the first to greet him. And Barry Bonds stands alone now with number 756. Now, Don, we have to digest what we've seen here. An unbelievable scene in San Francisco. But we do know that there are baseball fans around the country who do now and will still consider Henry Aaron the king. Numbers are not.
Well, he was,
and that's for time to decide, right?
That's the way I look at it. That's why I said it answers one big question, but it also is going to leave another number of others unanswered. And until those answers come through, let's treat it what it is, an amazing historical moment and an amazing number put on the board by that man.
And it's also a meaningful home run.
It gives
in a ball game like this, it gives them the lead.
Yeah. And think what you may of him. I know he's a competitor, and I think that obviously nothing is going to reach the magnitude of the record, but giving his team the lead with it, I think it will make it more special for him.
Now it's up to the Nationals to make sure it does not stand up as the game winner.
And it's going to be interesting to see if Mike Bassick can recover his wits and still go about his work. He still has a job to do.
One out in the bottom of the fifth inning. The Giants lead 5-4. And the moment an entire city and northern part of California have been waiting for has finally happened. And now, in the minds of many, time to move on. Ball one outside. Benji Molina, the hitter. And that's up and away, 2-0.
You mentioned before the difference in the baseballs. Some of the balls that they were, the balls they were using every time Bonds came up were marked specially so that when they go under like an ultraviolet light, you could see that they were Barry Bonds' special baseball. So that's very important in something of the magnitude of this.
And some very fortunate fan has that ball in his possession or her possession at the moment.
And will probably end up owning a small island.
Two balls and two strikes. Mike Bassick to Benji Molina. In August of 1976, the Bassick family was involved with Henry Aaron. As on August 23rd of that year, Mike Bassick Sr. pitched against Henry Aaron. And here, 31 years later, Mike Jr. gives up the all-timer to Barry Bonds.
Let's throw one more link in there, too. In the middle of the season in 1979, Mike Bassick Jr. faced Barry Bonds. Bobby Bonds, I'm sorry, Barry's father.
And a strike now to Ray Durham, who's walked and reached on an error tonight.
So through generations, the two families will be linked together.
There are no cheap homers to that part of this ballpark. That was a mighty blast for Bonds to get number 756. And a little pop up on the infield. Mike Bassick says, I'll take it. And the historical bottom of the fifth inning is over. With one out, Barry Bonds, right center. He knew it. Bassett knew it. 43,000 celebrating it. And baseball history has taken place. A go-ahead homer by Barry Bonds to give the Giants a 5-4 lead on number 756.